this is Teleosteris, and I decided with my recent acquisitions of two more Mosins to make an updated video showing my entire Mosin collection. And as you can see, I have 10 of them now. Starting from the bottom are my M39s, then M27, M91, an M91 Dragoon, and then four M91-30s, two of which are finished. And let's go down and for a little bit closer look. Alright, closer now. Of course, we will start off with my M39s, which are my favorite of the Mosin Nagants made by Finland. This is, of course, my favorite one, my one of the few straight-stocked M39s, made in 1941 at Sako. Love the dark pine tar finish. Then one of my more recent acquisitions was my 42 Sako. This one, of course, has the pistol grip stock and the dark wartime finish. Then we have the next M39. It was my very first Mosin Nagant, the one that started them all. And that is a VKT 1944 barrel, post-war build. So she doesn't have the dark pine tar finish, and she has the square joints, finger joints, all Arctic birch. Then next up is my finish M27 Mosin Nagant. The barrel was made in Tika, 1928, and she's definitely a Winter War veteran. You can see she's got the popsicle style upgrade from 1935. Also has the wing type front sight like the M39, but without the adjustable screw. And then next is my M91 emergency wartime build from 1942. Barrels from Tika. This is one of the ones they had. They were using up all the old parts. Kind of a lob sight. The blade front sight. And then up above is what I think a veteran of the Winter War, because is an M91 Dragoon. Big difference between these two, of course, is the Dragoon was smaller. And actually, that's what led to the M91-30. But this one was made in Tula in 1930. Has the Konovalov rear sight and such. And then we have here a Tika made 1944 M91-30 Finnish built with their two-piece hot belly stock. The receiver is one of the more uncommon round ones, because this was originally from a 1938 Tula. And of course it has the double stacked blade sight. So the Dragoon has just a single stack, double stack, because the sights were taller. And then up above here was a 91-30, originally made in Tula, 1936, one of the earlier round receiver ones. But this one was captured and rebuilt to a new stock, a Finnish stock, again with the potbelly stock, two-piece. And they modified the front sight so that it looks like they took the global front post and they kind of removed the top part, made it more like the wing sights, you know, like typical of the M39s and such. And those are, of course, my Finnish captures. And then we actually have my two Russian M91-30s. This one is my 1935 Tula. Had a hex receiver, obviously. Total post-war rebuild. You know, she's got the mark on the stock. So it's a new stock, new scuncheons. Total war, post-war refurb. And then, finally, my 1939 Tula round receiver, but she's got the screwed in scuncheons. She's wearing her original stock shop shows numerous repairs. Obviously, again, these are 9130s from Russia, Soviet Union, so these were with the Gobbler post sites. And, of course, she shows, you know, battle repairs. You know, this looks like a sniper mount, but she's not an ex-sniper, so I don't know why she's got that. But, you know, she's got a lot of repairs on the wood, but she's nice. And that's it. So, as of August 17th, 2012, that's my Mosin collection. Have a good one, and talk to you tomorrow. Hopefully the weather will be good for me to take my Dragoon out for her first shot. It's going to be fun. Woohoo! Bye.